An eye for an eye. So states the code of Babylonian King Hammurabi, one of the earliest and most complete set of laws. Kill and be killed. Yet today, over two-thirds of the world has abolished the death penalty, seeking to separate justice from the act of murder. Here in the United States, most states still allow the death penalty, and America remains the outlier amongst the world's democracies in enforcing the ultimate punishment. But what's the death penalty like around the world? How do different nations enforce it? Time to grab your passport and engage in a little dark tourism. United States. Starting here at home, the death penalty is legal in 30 states, with approximately 2,000 individuals awaiting their date with the Grim Reaper. Hanging and firing squad used to be the chief way to implement the death penalty, until states switched to the gas chamber and the electric chair for a more humane way to kill. Turns out both of those were far from humane, and today lethal injection remains the primary method of killing. Though mounting evidence is showing that lethal injection is also itself an extremely painful way of dying, prompting some states to consider bringing back the old-school alternatives like hanging and firing squad. The guillotine was also proposed, citing the efficiency and speed of death, but it seems like for now we'll be sticking with a lethal injection or perhaps a firing squad or two. China. The US gets a lot of flack for having the death penalty, but China is believed to execute thousands of people a year. It's difficult to get a precise count because the Chinese government works hard to suppress such unflattering business, but it's known that demand for executions is so high in China that the country purchased a fleet of death vans, which could quickly move from prison to prison, carrying out fast and efficient executions at each stop. With 46 criminal offenses mandating the death penalty, ranging from embezzlement to surrender of soldiers, it's no surprise China leads the way in deaths per year. China mainly executes via lethal injections, though it's not unheard of for firing squads to be occasionally used. Iran. With crimes such as drug trafficking and producing or distributing pornography grounds for the death penalty, it's no surprise that Iran puts up big numbers every year in executions. It's perhaps surprising that when it comes to murder, the state attempts to actually prevent an execution. The Iranian state considers murder a private matter between the offender and the family of the victim, and the family is given the choice. They can forgive the murderer and force them to pay a large financial restitution, or they can opt for the death penalty. The official sum owed to the family of a murder victim is the price of 100 camels, which must be paid in cash. Officially, if the victim was female, though, the family will only receive half that sum. Methods of execution in Iran include hanging, firing squad, and stoning. Because Iran somehow finds a way to be sexist even in executions, during a stoning, a man is buried to his waist and a woman to her neck. If the victim can escape the stoning pit before being killed, they're free to go. Unsurprisingly, men, who are only buried halfway, have a much greater chance of escape than women. Indonesia. Another country that brutally enforces anti-drug laws, Indonesia might be flirting with the idea of abolishing the death sentence, but it still routinely carries out executions, primarily against drug traffickers and producers. The preferred method of choice here is firing squad, though no official executioners exist. Instead, a special police unit carries out this grim task, receiving less than $100 on top of their regular pay for the job. Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia is a strict adherent to traditional and highly conservative Muslim law, which mandates execution by beheading for most crimes. While the firing squad will occasionally be used, nearly all executions are done by beheading. The condemned is led out to a courtyard where the crimes are read aloud. Then the executioner severs the head from the body with one quick stroke. While it might seem archaic, the truth is this is likely one of the most humane and fastest ways to bring about death. If the criminal was particularly heinous, the decapitated body is then crucified and put on public display for up to 3 days. For international reporters with a busy schedule, though, Saudi Arabia will be bringing execution to you and even spare your family the funeral expenses by shoving your body down a drain. Pakistan. Amongst the top three executioners in the world, alongside China and Iran, Pakistan has 27 crimes punishable by death. Perhaps unsurprisingly for such a strict religious fundamentalist nation, blasphemy is among these crimes, and is in fact considered one of the worst offenses. Defamation against the Quran will only net you life imprisonment, but defiling the sacred name of the Prophet Muhammad will almost certainly guarantee death. Homosexuality and piracy also bring the death penalty, as well as leaving the Islamic religion and joining a religion that is actively combating Islam, which is seen as treasonous. Yemen. Yemen may be a small nation, but it has one of the highest rates of execution per capita in the world. Here, the death penalty is invoked for any capital crime such as rape, murder, or terrorism. However, it can also be enforced for violations of Islamic law, such as adultery, sexual misconduct, sodomy, prostitution, and blasphemy. Though unlike Pakistan, these are very rare. While stoning, hanging, and beheading are all permitted under Yemeni law, Firing squad is the only form of execution in use today. Egypt. Another prolific executioner, Egypt maintains the death penalty for a variety of instances such as murder, terrorism, and rape. The death penalty can also be mandated in cases where an offense later leads to the death or severe bodily harm to others, such as in the case of the Port Said Stadium riot. The riot occurred when victorious football fans stormed the stands of the opposite side and began to violently attack them with clubs, rocks, and other improvised weapons. 74 people were killed, though most were because of the police's refusal to open the stadium gates, resulting in many people being crushed to death by the panicking crowd. 10 defendants were condemned to death for their part in the riot, with execution being carried out by hanging. Iraq. Frequently invoked by Saddam Hussein, ironically he himself would end up facing the death penalty for his crimes against the Iraqi people. In this country, car theft can net you the death penalty, as well as sabotage of the national economy, which is a catch-all term for piracy, bootlegging, and other forms of economic crime. Try to smuggle out large amounts of ancient artifacts from the country and you too could be facing death penalty in Iraq. The preferred method of execution here is by hanging. And after his capture, Saddam Hussein found his own end this way, a mercy for a man who brutally tortured and murdered thousands. United Arab Emirates. Another country with fundamentalist roots, the UAE maintains the death penalty for capital crimes such as treason, murder, aggravated robbery, and rape. However, the UAE also considers adultery and apostasy as capital crimes which carry the death penalty. The death penalty is rarely invoked, however, as the law requires that 3 judges all agree on the application of the death penalty. Like other fundamentalist countries, the UAE also gives the family of a victim the option of receiving a cash repayment rather than the offender facing the death penalty. If repayment is agreed upon, the sum for a murder is about $54,450, and the accused still faces 2 to 3 years of prison time. Most surprising of all, though, might be that the UAE enforces the death penalty for environmental crimes as well. Those facing the death penalty will meet their end via firing squad, with the execution often attended by the victim's family. North Korea. One of the last 4 countries to still make its executions public, the others being Iran, Saudi Arabia, and Somalia, North Korea is a strict adherent to the death penalty, perhaps unsurprising given the Kim family's tyrant grip on the nation. While you'll find capital offenses familiar to you already on the list of crimes deserving the death penalty, such as drug smuggling, treason, and murder, other crimes such as consumption of foreign media or attempt to convert people to a religion and away from the Juche ideology also merit the death penalty in the Hermit Kingdom. The main methods employed in North Korea include the firing squad, hanging, and decapitation, though many criminals see themselves condemned, often along with their families, to lifelong imprisonment in camps, where they'll be worked or beaten to death, and sometimes even medically experimented on. Personally offending the dear leader can also lead to the death penalty, such as when actress Woo In-hee was married but having an affair with Kim Jong-il, cheated on him by having an affair with a third man, and was publicly executed via firing squad. Now go check out what life in death row is like. In Death Row, Japan vs. United States, what's the difference? Or click this other video instead.